Welcome. My name is Marc Shipman-Mueller, and I'm a product manager at ARRI. You're watching one in a series of ARRI Tech Talk videos that describe the features of the Alexa 35. I'm assuming that you already have watched the Alexa 35 guided tour to get an overview of the camera. If you've not, please do so, because in this video here, we will do a deep dive into the world of the 19 Alexa 35 recording formats. Before I start, let's give you a little overview. These 19 recording formats are designed on an extensive industry survey. The interesting thing we found was that different people wanted very different things. Some wanted to maximize the data rate, others wanted to maximize the image circle, and yet others wanted top frames per second. So we designed these 19 recording formats to make sure that every production can find just the recording format they need. These recording formats also include some time savers, like in-camera de-squeeze or in-camera downsample, that are available in the ProRes options. All but three very obvious ones fulfill the streamer's 4K mandate, and I will point those out. You can record in the Alexa 35 in MXF ARRIRAW or MXF Apple ProRes. Now, ARRIRAW is our uncompressed, unencrypted, and uncompromised sensor data format that gives you the maximum image quality. It gives you the greatest flexibility in post, and is really best for future archiving, which is why a lot of the streamers right now are pushing for it. With high density encoding, downstream file size can even be reduced by 40%. Apple ProRes, on the other hand, is a compressed image data format. It's available in ProRes 422HQ, 4x4, and 4x4XQ. ProRes gives you immediate access to the data. You pop the card into a Mac, and you can immediately play back your data. And with the ProRes recording formats, we've also tried to make your life as easy as possible and save you post steps, though there are some extra time-saving options. Here's a list of all 19 Alexa 35 recording formats. The first thing you have to understand is the naming convention. In this column here, you see the sensor mode. The sensor mode defines the area on the sensor that we're capturing. This is important to figure out if the image circle of your lens actually covers. This other column here is the recording resolution. That defines the number of pixels that actually get recorded into the file, maybe including a ProRes downsample or a ProRes in anamorphic de-squeeze. Now let's look at each of the 19 recording formats. We're starting with OpenGate. If you can afford it, OpenGate is the best and easiest recording format. It gives you maximum image quality, maximum image area, and maximum resolution. OpenGate works great for spherical and anamorphic lenses, and many shows use OpenGate, and then they create custom frame lines inside OpenGate, and then they use the rest as padding, which is great for visual effects, resizing, repositioning, stabilizing, or tracking. OpenGate has a relatively large sensor area, so you should make sure that your lens image circle covers OpenGate. Here we see ARRIRAW OpenGate, and we have exactly the same also available in ProRes. Next, we have a 4.6K 16x9 format. This is the full width of the sensor, but less height. If you're shooting with a spherical lens, this format gives you all the advantages of OpenGate, but with about 1.5 times lower data rate. We have this in ARRIRAW, but it's also available in ProRes. In ProRes, however, we're trying to help you a little bit, so we're actually downsampling it in the camera to 4K to 4096 pixels wide. The next format is 4K 16x9. This is great if you shoot with spherical lenses and you're looking for a 16x9, a 1.85 to 1, or a 2.39 to 1 deliverable. This is also great if you're shooting UHD and you want a little extra padding around your image for visual effects, for resizing, rotating, or tracking in post. This is a smaller sensor area than OpenGate or 4.6K 16x9 to ensure that all Super 35 lenses cover. Now we have this in ARRIRAW, and we also have it in ProRes, same thing. And then in ProRes, there's some extra options. You can ask the camera to downsample it to UHD, which is 3840 by 2160, or you can ask the camera to downsample it even further to a 2K image, which is one of the three formats that does not fulfill the 4K mandate. And then you can also ask the camera to downsample it to an HD image. Then we have 4K 2:1. 2:1 is a very, very popular aspect ratio right now, and we're trying to make it easier for people to shoot 2:1 aspect ratio images. So if you're shooting with spherical lenses, you're looking for a 2-to-1 result, this is the format that you can use. This is a smaller sensor area than open gate or 4.6K 16x9, so all Super 35 lenses cover. We have this in ARRIRAW, and we also have the same available in ProRes. Now it's becoming fun. Now we're looking at anamorphic lenses. 3.3K 6x5 is our format for shooting with 2x anamorphic lenses. Now, does this fulfill the 4K mandate, you may ask? Yes, it does. What the streamers are saying is you should have the same number of photo sites on the sensor as 4K UHD. Now, 4K UHD is 3840 by 2160, so 3840 multiplied by 2160 equals 8.29 megapixels. As long as you have more than 8.29 megapixels, you should be fine, and our 3.3K 6x5 image format has 10 megapixels. You're totally fine. And those that need even more can shoot open gate and create their own 3.8K 6x5 custom frame line, and that'll get them 12 megapixels. We have this available in ARRIRAW. We also have the same available in ProRes. And then in ProRes, we have the option of doing a de-squeeze and a resample in camera, and that gets you a 4K 2.39:1 image. Next in our line of anamorphic formats is 3K 1:1. This is if you're shooting with anamorphic 2x lenses for a 2:1 deliverable. Very, very popular format. We have this available in ARRIRAW and in ProRes. And again, in ProRes, you can ask the camera to do a de-squeeze and a downsample. And here you now get a UHD result, 3840 wide. The next formats are only available in Apple ProRes. The first one is a 2.7K 8:9. This is for projects using anamorphic 2x lenses that have a 16x9 deliverable. So you start out with a relatively tall area on the sensor, you do a de-squeeze and resample in the camera, and you end up with a 3840 by 2160, that's a UHD 16x9 image that you can use immediately, go to edit, and it makes the workflow really, really fast. Last but not least is a 2K format that's specifically designed for shooting with 16mm lenses. It is, if you want, a 16x9 or 1.85:1 result shooting with spherical lenses, and those can be 16mm lenses. So that allows you to use all the existing 16mm lenses with the Alexa 35. As you saw, the Alexa 35 provides 19 different recording formats, so each production can find the right recording format for their project. From a big Hollywood feature film to a small in-house commercial, the Alexa 35 has got you covered. Thank you very much for watching.